Guys, let us look at some pathology spotters in slides, okay? So what do you think this is? So basically, what you see here, orphan Annie eye appearance, correct? So it is papillary thyroid carcinoma. You can clearly see orphan Annie eye appearance, right? Guys, can you see the orphan Annie eyes? Right? Ground glass appearance. So this is papillary carcinoma of thyroid, okay? What do you think this is? So can you see some glandular or villi kind of appearance here? What do you think this is? A lot of lymph kind of a structure here. So basically here this is acute appendicitis. Here you should be able to see inflammatory exudate in the lumen with neutrophils. Mucous membrane should be congested, ulcerated, lost at places. There should be neutrophilic infiltration into the layers of the appendix. And then you should see, what else? Congested blood vessels. Yes. Okay. So this is appendicitis. Now let's take the next one. What do you think this is? So let me tell you what you see here. You see fat, right? Accumulation of fat within hepatocytes. So you have microvesicular type, macrovesicular type, right? So fatty cysts, you can, should be able to see. Then when you stain it, you will see with the Sudan stain, etc., that you leave here. So basically, this is fatty liver. Fatty liver is caused because of alcoholism, starvation, malnutrition, diabetes mellitus, obesity, right? And the complication, this can lead to further liver cirrhosis. So look at this and tell if you can guess what it is. So there is some fat here. Here there is, seems to be some kind of an additional color, though it's not very clear here. So this is comedonecrosis. So you should be able to see around the comedonecrosis some tumor cells, right? Basically, you will see tumor cells in tubules. So here you are able to see some fat, right? So this is infiltrating ductal carcinoma. So basically, the tumor cells, small, round to oval, closely packed, and they are separated by dense stroma. So basically the stroma will be having hard consistency. So basically typical things here will be the mitotic figures, hyperchromatic nuclei, large nuclei, etc. What do you think this is? It's not very clear, but it is actually, you should be able to see Reed-Sternberg cells in this. So basically this is Hodgkin lymphoma, guys. Look at it, if you can see some details here. So basically, this is a neoplasm of the lymphoid tissue. The normal architecture of the lymph node is distorted. You'll be seeing tumor giant cells like Reed-Sternberg cells, right? So these can be mononucleate or binucleate, owl's eye appearance. So they will have a prominent eosinophilic nucleoli. Nucleoli is eosinophilic, okay? So what you'll see here, other than this, you will see lymphocytes, eosinophils, histiocytes, granulocytes. You will see a lot of cells here. What cells you will see here? Histiocytes, lymphocytes, plasma cells, classic Reed-Sternberg cells. You will see neutrophils. You will see eosinophils. You will see what are the subtypes of Hodgkin's lymphoma? You have nodular sclerosis, mixed cellularity, lymphocyte rich, lymphocyte depletion, etc. Right? So all this you should know. What do you think this is? You can see different types of cells here. So this is a teratoma. Okay. So basically here you will see glands, stratified squamous lining. That is very typical, right? Stratified squamous lining. Cartilage, you should be able to see. Smooth muscle, you should be able to see. Columnar lining, adipocytes, right? Sebaceous glands, is it? So basically teratoma is a germ cell tumor. It usually consists of all three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. It can be either mature, that is benign, or immature, that is malignant. And it can be even monodermal, that is specialized, like struma ovari, right? So basically, it is a example you can give is a dermoid cyst of ovary, right? So what are the structures you can have in this? Sebaceous glands, sweat glands, hair follicles, cartilage, bone, respiratory epithelium, intestinal epithelium, etc., right? That's a teratoma. Take the next guess. So you see this one. And the clue here is that there is a purple body here. What is this? Actinomycetes. So what is actinomycetes? Actinomycosis. So we are talking here about actinomycosis, guys. So actinomycosis, basically, here you are seeing a Splendor Hopley phenomena, right? Where this this thing here is a Splendor Hopley phenomena. You are able to see sulfur, right? Sulfur granules which are blue. You should be able to see peripheral clubs, sulfur granules. This is Splendor Hopley phenomena in actinomycosis. Sorry, actinomycosis. Actinomycosis is actually a disease caused by anaerobic bacteria Actinomyces israeli. Okay. So in this, there are some types and all that, abdominal, pelvic, thoracic, etc. Even cervicofacial, actually cervicofacial is the most common, they are saying. The inflammatory reaction with central suppuration is seen. Okay. So there will be pustules in this. Obviously, it's a bacterial infection, so pustules will be there. So the center of the lesion shows abscess, and at the periphery, you can see chronic inflammatory cells, etc. The central suppurative area, that is this area, what is shown here, it contains of bacterial colonies which show bluish stained mycelium and peripheral eosinophilic material. This is Splendor Hopley phenomena. So you will draw this kind of purple body, and here you will draw a lot of neutrophils because it is a bacterial infection. Okay. So can you guess what this is? So here you can see some kind of a lymphoid follicles type of a thing here. That is the clue here. What do you think this is? This is, wait, let's look at the features. So here you should see lymphoid follicles with germinal centers, kind of, yes, we can see that. Glands which are lined by Hurthle cells. So you got the clue here. It is Hashimoto's thyroiditis. So you should not see any colloid in the, not much colloid because it is having hypothyroidism, right? So basically, you will see lymphoid follicles with germinal centers. You will see glands with Hurthle cells, but there will be no colloid here. These Hurthle cells are actually oncocytes, right? So this is an autoimmune disease, destruction of thyroid gland. There is infiltration of lymphocyte plasma cell, macrophages, immunoblasts, etc. You will see lymphoid follicles having germinal centers. They are devoid of, the follicles are reduced in number. They are devoid of colloid. The follicular epithelial cells undergo metaplasia, and that is called as Hurthle cells, okay, or oxophilic cells or oncocytes or Ashkenazi cells, okay. So they have lot of cytoplasm, okay. So these cells have lot of cytoplasm. These are Hurthle cells, oncocytes there, okay. So this is Hashimoto's thyroiditis. What do you think this is? Maybe it's difficult to guess only in this view, wait. But you can actually see in this that, wait, let me zoom just a little more. You can see here that this kind of appearance is very clear actually, septa, right? Nodular kind of, so this is cirrhosis of liver. So in these you will actually see the fibrous septa divide the hepatic parenchyma into nodules. So you can see nodules here. So there is distortion of lobular architecture. You will not be able to spot the central vein, right? The portal triad and central vein are not made out in regenerative nodules. So basically, what are they telling here? Uniform sized micronodules, fatty change, fibrous septa. Ductular proliferation, they're saying the ducts are proliferating. And what are the complications of cirrhosis of liver? Portal hypertension, hepatic encephalopathy, hepatocellular carcinoma. Let's move on to the next one. What do you think this is? So let's see what you can see here. You can see mucosa lined by tall columnar epithelium. Are you able to see that? Mononuclear inflammatory cells. Hypertrophied muscularis layer, Rokitansky-Ashoff sinus. So are you able to see any Rokitansky-Ashoff sinus? Some deep sinus you should be able to see, deep sinus. Okay, Rokitansky-Ashoff sinus. Okay, fibrosis, some perinuclear, perimuscular fibrosis. So this is chronic cholecystitis, guys. So basically inflammation of the gallbladder. Penetration of mucosa deep into the wall of gallbladder up to the muscularis layer to form Rokitansky-Ashoff sinus. Chronic inflammatory cells are seen in the lamina propria. variable degree of fibrosis of perimuscular layer. So it can, this is chronic cholecystitis. Usually it can be associated with gallstones. Can you identify this one? This is not difficult, guys. So you can see giant cells here, right? Stroma, giant cells. So this is osteoclastoma. So it is a giant cell tumor, benign condition of the bone. So basically osteoclastic giant cells are there. Okay. But these are not tumor cells. These only look like osteoclasts. They are, the actual stromal cells are actually the tumor cells, remember? Okay. So basically osteoclastoma, where will you see? In the epiphysis of the long bone. So usually the knee joint, you will see the lower end of femur, upper end of tibia, right, etc. So basically in this you'll have two types of cells, giant cells and stromal cells. Giant cells are numerous, they will have around 100 nuclei, but these are non-neoplastic. What are neoplastic are actually the stromal cells. So if this is a giant cell with lot of nuclei, this is a very, very innocent guy, nothing wrong here. But the stromal cells are actually the tumor cells. How are the stromal cells? They are spindle shaped oval cells with vesicular nuclei and indistinct cytoplasmic borders. So vesicular nuclei. So how will you draw that? If this is the cytoplasm, this is the nucleus. The nucleoli will be like this. So vesicular nuclei, okay, in the stromal cells. So there will be areas of hemorrhage, necrosis, hemosiderin, pigments, etc. So you will actually see soap bubble appearance in the radiology. So what do you think this one is now? So let me give you a clue. It is actually hemangioma. Just say whether it is capillary hemangioma or cavernous hemangioma. How do you differentiate that? Okay, let's look at that. So basically, this is capillary hemangioma. Okay. So it is capillary hemangioma. So it is a benign neoplasm of the blood vessel. So blood vessel, benign condition. This is hemangioma. So basically the lesion is unencapsulated. That's what it says here. So here you should be able to see skin. So that is what you're seeing here. You are seeing the epidermis here. So that is a giveaway for you, right? So you're seeing the epidermis here. So basically you will see lobule of thin walled capillaries. So thin walled capillaries you should be able to see here. Here you should be able to see thin walled capillaries. Plump endothelium will be there for the capillaries. The capillaries will have plump endothelium. And these capillaries, between them there will be fibrous septa. Okay. So there will be lobule of thin walled capillaries. So this thing becomes a lobule. Similarly, you can have one more lobule. So basically the capillaries will be having plump endothelium. Okay. So it will be having plump endothelium. You should be able to see the epidermis. So this is capillary hemangioma. Look at this one now. It is having large cavernous spaces filled with blood. So this is cavernous hemangioma. Okay. This will have flattened endothelium. It will not have plump endothelium. And hepatic parenchyma. So this is in the liver they are seeing. So this is hepatic parenchyma. Benign neoplasm of blood vessel, the lesion again is unencapsulated in this, composed large number of thin-walled intercommunicating cavernous vascular spaces, partly or completely filled with blood. Okay, so basically they have flattened endothelial cells separated by connective tissue stroma, wherein all you will see this liver, brain, etc. So you will see it in von Hippel-Lindau disease, cavernous hemangioma. So how will you draw this? If it is the liver, you can draw a hepatocyte, central vein. Let's draw the central vein here. Central vein, lot of hepatocytes, right? Like this kind of lobular architecture. Alright. And you will draw a lot of blood capillaries filled with blood. And it will have flattened epithelium, endothelium in this. Remember, in capillary hemangioma, epidermis near the skin, and you will have plump endothelium. Here you have flattened endothelium, liver, brain, etc. You can see this. So let's go to the next one here. What do you think this is? Give it a thought. Let's meet in the next video, because this video is already quite long. Let's meet in the next video to continue the histology spotters, histopathology spotters.